So next term in the nomenclature, pressure angle of the gear, right? So this is also known as angle of obliquity, right? Pressure angle of gear or angle. It's important to note that the gears must have same pressure angles to mesh. So as usual, like other parameters, like pitch values, right? Pitch values, the pressure angle also must be same for both the gears. Right? Otherwise, the mating will not be proper and the power transmission and the motion transmission will not be effective. Okay, 14.5 degrees pressure angle. Will not mesh with the 20 degrees pressure angle gears and vice versa. That means the pressure angle must be same for both the gear wheels. Okay, look at the gear tooth profiles for different pressure angles. Right? So 14.5 degrees pressure angle, 20 degrees pressure angle, and 25 degrees pressure angle. Okay, in as the pressure angle is less, right, you will get uniform cross section starting from the base to the top lander. Okay, so if the pressure angle is zero, whatever the cross sectional area you will have at the bottom land, you can continue same pressure cross sectional area till the this top lander. You will not get this inclination. Okay, this slope will not get if the pressure angle is zero. Okay, as the pressure angle is increased, slowly the slope of this surface, increases. That means the curvature increases. That's why look at the 25 degrees pressure angle profile, get to the profile here. The curvature is more compared with the curvature of this 14.5 degrees pressure angle, right? So here the engagement is very much easier. And you can avoid the interference also. That means the penetration of pinion teeth or gear teeth into other profiles. Okay. So, but here you will get a sharp edge at this portion. Right. This sharp edge may cause the interference. Interference is nothing but digging of pinion teeth into the gear teeth or digging of gear teeth into the pinion teeth. That means it forms some type of a groove or it makes some type of depression to the surface of other gear teeth. Right? That means the shape of this gear tooth profile is slightly disturbed or deviated. Right? That is called the interference. That interference should be avoided, otherwise you will not get a proper motion transmission or the power transmission. Right? The interference is more in this low pressure angle gears and the interference is very less in this high pressure angle gears. Okay, but apart from this, the tooth thickness, because the base width is more and slowly the width is or the cross section is reduced when it reaches to the top land. That's why the strength is also more. Okay, okay, but here there is a chance of slippage. Right, and there is a higher backlash if you consider this type of teeth. Right, to compensate these two disadvantages, the medium pressure angle between 14.5 and 25 degrees, 20 degrees pressure angle is best suited for the power transmission. And now this is the most widely used pressure angle in the gear drives. The increase of the pressure angle from 14.5 degrees to 25 degrees results in stronger teeth, because the tooth acting as a acts as a beam wider at the base. Right, by combining these pressure angles and gear tooth profiles, we have 14.5 degrees envolute profile, 14.5 degrees cycloidal profile like this. We'll see the profiles later. Now contact ratio, this is another important term in the gear drives. Contact ratio is nothing but the number of gear teeth in contact. Number of gear teeth in contact is nothing but the contact ratio. It is considered as one gear tooth in contact for simplicity. More than one tooth is actually in contact during the engagement, and therefore the load is partially shared with another pair of teeth. This property is called contact ratio. Okay, so simply you can remember that the number of teeth in contact, number of pairs of teeth in contact, right? So don't think that always one teeth of pinion engaged with another one teeth of gear, right? So parallelly, number of teeth are in engagement, starting from point of engagement to point of disengagement, right? So the point of engagement to point of disengagement, you will have certain length. That length is called length of engagement. That will be split into a length of approach and length of recess. We will discuss later on the equations to calculate these values, right? So now here you need to understand number of teeth in engagement is nothing but contact ratio, right? Don't think that always one teeth is in engagement, one teeth is in mating, or one teeth is in meshing. The contact ratio between 1 and 2 means the part of the time two pairs of teeth are in contact, and during the remaining time one pair of teeth is in contact. That means if the contact ratio is 1.5, right? So one teeth is always in contact and remaining second teeth is in contact only for the 50% of this time. Okay, so that's what here it is specified. The ratio between 2 and 3 means 2 or 3 pairs of teeth are always in contact, right? 2 teeth are always in contact and the third pair is only in contact with part of the time. Higher the contact ratio, more the load is shared between the teeth. So this is obvious. If the contact teeth, if the contact is between more number of teeth, obviously higher value of load will be shared from gear to pinion. So obviously the load carrying capacity is also increases. It is a good practice to maintain contact ratio between 1.3 to 1.8. Okay, so if you want to consider more contact ratio, the curvature must be less. That means the radius of curvature must be high. If you consider higher radius of curvature, the diameters of gear and pinion will be higher. As the diameters increases, you cannot accommodate gear drive with the limited spaces. Okay, obviously the compactness of gear drive disappears. Okay, that is one of the advantage. Gear drive is highly compact. Compared with the belt drives. If we consider higher contact ratio, you need to go for higher sizes of gear wheels, whether it is a gear or a pinion. Okay, under no circumstances should the contact ratio drop below 1.1. So if the contact is less than one pair of teeth, then there is no meaning at all, right? Minimum one teeth must be in contact.